क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री, पेज नंबर 76, क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री। We find the two numbers whose sum is 27 and product is 182. Whose sum is 27 and product is your 182. Now see, the summation of two numbers is given 27. So if one number is x, what will be the another number?
27 minus 6.
So write down. Let the first number be x. Let the first number be x. Then another number will be 27 minus x. So let the first number be x, then the another number be 27 minus x. Another number be 27 minus x. Now see, the product is given 182. So the product of the two numbers is given 182. So according to question, what will be the equation?
X into 27 minus 6 is equal to 182.
Yes. X into 27 minus x equal to 182. Now simplify it. It will be 27x minus x square. If you take 182, the left hand side will be 1 minus 182 equal to 0. Now multiply both sides by negative sign, so it will be x square minus 27x plus 182 equal to 0. Now you have to break 27 such that the product will be 182 and summation will be 27. So the process is, you have to take the what? You have to factorize. So 2 9 is 18, 2 1 is 2. Then 7 13 is what? 91. Listen, no, 13 7 is 91. 13 7 is 91. So now see, now we need 27 minus 27. Listen, no. So see, 7 into 2 14 and 13. If you add 14 and 13, it will be 27. Yes or no? So that is, it will be minus 14x minus 13x plus 182 equal to 0. Now see, this will be the your that means we have to your break minus 27 as minus 14 and minus 13. Now see, if you multiply minus 14 and minus 13, your answer will be 182 plus 182. Why? Because it is minus and minus sign is there. So if two minus sign are there, then when you multiply, it will be plus. So it will be plus 182. Now take common here, it will be x minus 14. Then take 13 common, it will be x minus 14. Because minus sign is there, so to become, if you take minus 13 common, then your this sign will be minus negative. So it will be x minus 13 into x minus 14 equal to 0. So write down. So x minus 13 equal to 0 or x minus 14 equal to 0. So x equal to 13. Or x equal to 14. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So again, the previous question we solved. That means you will get, suppose if x is 13, then the other number will be 27 minus 13. If x is 14, the other number will be 27 minus 14. So write down. Now, if first number, 1 minute. If first number be 13, then another or other number be 27 minus 13, right? So it will be 14. Again, if all of you mute the sound, the first number be 14, then another number be 27 minus 14 equal to 13. Here?
Yes.
Okay. Can I proceed to the next one? Can I proceed to the next one? That consecutive positive integer, now see, 1. The consecutive integer 1 is, it can be either 0 or 2. Okay. So no, or suppose 0. Consecutive consecutive integer means it can be either minus 1 or 1.
Or 1.
But if it is positive integer, consecutive positive, then it will be 1. Understand? Mm. So in the same way, see the next question. Find out two conjugative positive integers, sum of whose square is 365. Sum of whose square is 365. Try to understand this one. Sum of whose square is 365. Sum of whose square is 365 means what? Anyone? Sum of whose square is 365. That means?
That means, sir, that number square.
Yes.
Means.
Yes, that means suppose one number is x, then the conjugative positive integer will be x plus 1. Then according to question, x plus 1 whole square will be equal to 365. You understand? Sum of whose square is 365. So all of you write down. Let the conjugative positive integers be. Let the conjugative positive integers be number 4. Let the conjugative positive integers be x and x plus 1. Now, according to the question, the sum of conjugative positive integer, that means the sum of the square of the conjugative positive integer, that means your x square plus x plus 1 whole square, that is equal to 365. Now solve this. X square, this is a plus b whole square, so it will be x square plus 2x plus 1 equal to 365. Now x square plus x square, it will be 2x square, then 2x plus 1 minus 365 equal to 0. Now it will be 2x square plus 2x minus, it will be 364 equal to 0. Now divide this one by 2, so it will be x square plus x minus 2 1 the 2 16, 2 8 the 16, 2 2 the 4 1 32. Now all of you break this. Now see, here the this term is negative. This term is negative. So that means when you break this, one term will be, that means when you break this, one term will be positive and one term will be negative. Yes or no? Then the multiplication will be negative. such way in that way you have to break the this. Now see, this is what is the b here, what is the value of b here?
1.
So first factorize 182. 2 9 the same, it is, yes or no? Man, then 7 13 the 91, same this one also, yes or no? After dividing 364 by 2, you will get 182. Now factor. Now see here, see this one here, this is minus 27, so you have to add, yes or no? Minus 14 minus 13, but here it is 1. So what will be the, how can you break? But one term will be positive, one term will be negative.
14x minus 13x.
Yes, good. So it will be this one 14 and this one 13. Now all of you have to see this one, how you factorize, okay? Write down, give it a straight line and write down this one. X square, then it will be 14x minus 13x minus 182. Now see, the product is minus, that means the product of the coefficient of x square and c is minus 182. Minus 182. Now see, when you multiply 14 with minus 13, the product will be minus 182. So now take common x, it will be x plus 14. Now here take minus 13 common, then it will be again x, then here minus sign is 1 minute. Yes, minus sign is there. Now see, to become minus, it will be plus, yes or no? If you take minus 13 common, to become minus, it will be plus, because minus and plus will be minus. So 14. Now it will be x plus 14 and x minus 13 equal to 0. Oh, now see, it will be x plus 14 equal to 0 or x minus 13 equal to 0. Now here it will be from here minus 14 and it will be plus 13. Now see, is it possible that the value of x is negative? Is it possible?
No.
Why? Because because we have, we let that conjugative positive integer, yes or no? So value cannot be negative. But if it is not there, positive word is not there, then we can take the value as minus also, negative also. But in the question itself, it says that conjugative positive integers. So write down, since the integers are conjugative positive integers, since the integers are conjugative positive integers, so x cannot be minus 14. This genus cannot be minus 14. Hence, we have x equal to 13. Now see, we need two integers, yes or no? So if x first integer will be x, that is 13, then next integer will be 13 plus 1, 14, yes or no? So then, so the conjugative positive integers are 13 and 14 means this one, 13 plus 1, 14 respectively. Clear all of you?
Yes.
Okay. Will be clear?
Yes.
Okay. The next question. Question number 5. The altitude of a right angle is 7 cm less than its base. If the hypotenuse is if the hypotenuse is 13 cm, find the other two sides. Have you remembered Pythagoras theorem?
Yes.
What is the Pythagoras theorem? Anyone?
Perpendicular square is equal to hypotenuse square is equal to
base square plus perpendicular
what
square.
Noise. Yes.
So now see, first all of you draw one triangle. Right angle triangle. Now see, altitude means what? Altitude means
height.
Height, yes. So suppose this is the height, this is the base, and this is the pure hypotenuse. This is a triangle A, B, C. Now see the question. The altitude of a right triangle is 7 cm less than its base. Yes or no? Let me suppose if base is your x centimeter, then altitude will be how much?
X minus 8.
Yes, x minus 7 centimeter. Now hypotenuse is given how much? 13 centimeter. Now you have to find the other two sides. That means x and x minus 7. So write down. Write down like this. In the figure, ABC is a right triangle. Right triangle. Okay. Next, I don't let base of the right triangle equal right angle within the iron BC within bracket iron BC equal to x centimeter. So then this given in the question that altitude is 7 cm less than the base, then altitude of the right angle within the guidance AB equal to x minus 7 centimeters and hypotenuse is given cm. So we have 10 minutes and again we will join. Hypotenuse 13 cm. Now see, find the other two sides. So you have to apply Pythagoras theorem. So write down.
Yes.
By applying Pythagoras theorem, we have 13 square equal to perpendicular, that means your x minus or altitude x minus 7 whole square plus x square. Now solve this. What is the value of 13 square? I told you in the class 9 now. So you have to at least remember
169.
Yes, 169.
Good. Yes, good. At least square of up to what? 20, yes or no? What is 17 square? Anyone?
289.
Good, very good.
Which one?
17 square. 18 square. 324.
How did you say?
324. Now see here, x square, then 14x, then 49 plus x square. So it will be x square plus x square, 2x square, 14x plus 49. Now solve this. 169 minus 2x squared plus 14x minus 49 equal to 0. Now if you subtract 49 from 169, what will be the value? 120 minus 2x squared plus 14 is equal to 0. Now multiply both sides by minus negative sign, so it will be 2x squared minus 14x minus 120 equal to 0. Now see, you have in quadratic equation, always remember you have to simplify to the smallest term. Now see here, 2x square minus 14x minus 120. So you can divide both the terms by 2, yes or no? So always remember, don't keep the equation like this. You have to convert it into smallest term. So it will be x square, then divide 2x square by 2. Divide 14x will be 7x, it will be 60, and 0 divided by 2 will be 0, yes or no? Now break this one. Again, I am writing the equation here. Equation is your x square minus 7x minus 60 equal to 0. Now see, 60 factorize it. 230 is 60, 215 is 30, 53 is 15. Now see, again see, here negative sign is there, here also negative sign. So that means one term will be your positive, one term will be negative, yes or no? Then it will be negative. Now see here, how going to break 60? We need the 60, product is 60, 60 into 1, so 60. Now see, 5, yes, 5 to the 10 and 2 to the 6. So if you subtract here, 1 minute, no, it will be wrong. Now see, 2 to the 4,
to the
yes,
10.
No, it will be wrong. See this one.
5 to the 10 and 3 to the 6.
Then 10 minus 6 will be 4, no. So it will be wrong. Now see this one. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 12. So if you subtract 5 from the 12, it will be 7. Yes or no?
Yes.
So do like this. But the bigger one will be minus, yes or no? That means 12 will be minus because minus sign is there. So it will be x square minus 12x plus 5x minus 60 equal to 0. Usually, do you understand this one? How break this one? Do you understand? Now see, when you multiply 12 minus 12 and 5, it will be minus 60. Now x, take x common, it will be minus 12. Then 5 common, then it will be again 5, 12 is 60. So it will be x plus 5 into x minus 12 equal to 0. That means x plus 5 equal to 0 or x minus 12 equal to 0. So x will be minus 5 or x will be 12. Now see, this cannot be minus 5. Why? Because in a triangle, this is a what? Base cannot be negative, yes or no?
Yes.
So that's why it cannot be negative. We can't take it negative. Write down. Since base of a triangle cannot be negative value, so x cannot be minus 5. X cannot be minus 5. Comma, we have x equal to 12. Now see, if x equal, that means we have to find the two other side. Except your hypotenuse, we need the two other sides. So if one is your base 12, it will be 5, yes or no? So write down hence the base of the right triangle is 12 centimeter. And now see, base is 12 centimeter. Altitude will be 12 minus 7. Yes or no? And it's altitude. Unmute the sound. Some sound is coming. I think Dipjyoti. And altitude is 12 minus 7, it is 5 centimeters. Here, all of you.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Where have you gone, huh?
Sir?
What was it?
Sir, what's wrong with you? Garmi cool.
All of you, we will end the class here again. We'll join after 2 minutes. Okay.
Okay, sir. Here's this one.